Hello everybody, I welcome you to Nurse Life TV. Thank you so much for clicking and giving us a thumbs up and for sharing. God bless you all so much. So quick one, let me go straight into my video. I don't want to make it too long. I want to make it short and sweet so you can go on to the next video you want to watch. I'm here to share one of my experiences whilst in Chamberlain University. You see, my last two classes, collaborative healthcare and capstone, okay? So instead of they making me take both classes together, they divided it. So I had one collaborative by itself, and then the last session I had the capstone, whilst my other students, my colleagues, my friends, they were taking two classes because they still had other classes that I had already done through another school that was accepted by Chamberlain. Long story short, what do I want to share with you today? So in Chamberlain, at the beginning, the first week of the course, what they make us do is to write a med calculation exam, med calc exams. So it's a math dosage calculation. Yes, a dosage calculation exam. Okay, I didn't bring my video stand, so I'm moving my hands too much, forgive me. So dosage calculation, it can make you or break you depending on the school that you are in. So in Chamberlain, at Chamberlain we have three attempts, if I'm not mistaken. Yes, and believe you me, in collaborative healthcare course, I had to do dosage calculation three times. On the third one, when I failed the second one, I called in my prayer warriors. Because if you fail, you are out of the class. Yep. If you fail dosage calculation, they kick you out of the class. And here is, and in collaborative, we are supposed to get 20 over 20. Yep. And in capstone, we are supposed to get 20 over 20. Before that, if you get up to 19 over 20, 18 over 20, they allow you. But the last two classes, you had to get 20 over 20. So I called my prayer partners in Ghana, West Africa. I said, look guys, I have come this far. I didn't come this far to fail. This math, and it is not like I don't know. The professor herself sent me an email. She said, Rosalyn, now we know you're a smart person. You're a registered nurse, so we know you're a smart person. Okay, it's just an oversight on your part that is making you put the wrong answer. We have to type in our answer. She said, take your time. This is the final attempt. Take your time. Okay, go through the question like three times. Okay, so you choose the right answer. So some of them we type in our answer, some of them you choose from the answers. So like I said, I had to call for reinforcement, and then I said, Rosalyn, you got this, you got this, you got it. And I tell you, the collaborative that week, that first week, and the capstone that first week, both those moments or those weeks, I was stressed out, okay? I was very stressful. Very stressful. Marital issues, other family issues, you know, work issues, so many life challenges. I know I'm speaking to somebody here. I'm making this video so that when that time comes, when you are faced with challenges, whether it's any of what I've just mentioned or something else, watch this video. Let it motivate you. Number one, I woke up the morning, I said, Rosalyn, you have not come this far to fail. You got this. You're gonna make it. Okay? You have not come this far to fail. I have to keep repeating to myself these positive things. I have to keep repeating to myself that I haven't come this far to fail. I haven't come this far to fail. I'm a conqueror. I am more than overcomer. I'm the best of the best. I'm the head and never the tail. I am God's favorite. And failure is not my portion. Positive affirmation. So that's my number one point to you. Positive affirmation. So I kept saying it over and over and over. That day that I was going to take my final attempt, I kept saying it. Before that, I had prayed with my prayer warriors because I'm a spiritual person and I believe that everything about our life is very spiritual. Okay, I don't over spiritualize things, but I am a spiritual person. You can't take that from me. You're a spiritual being, whether you like it or yes. So, number one, positive affirmation. Number two, prayers. I ask God to help me, the heavens to back me, because I'm a child of God and I'm born to lead. Failure is not my portion. I claim, and the word of God says that whatever I would decree, it shall be established. So I began to make declaration that I have passed this last one in Jesus' name. I kept praying and praying. And then I said positive things. And then I went over. The teacher met me one-on-one. We went through all the sample questions that is similar to what I was going to take again. So we went through that. So she will calculate it. I'll be giving her the next step. And then she asked me, what will be your answer? I calculated, I give it. She said, you got this, Rosalyn. We know you got it. It's just you rushing through the whole thing. So what am I telling you? Med calc, dosage calculation. You got this, my sisters, my brothers. You got this, okay? Don't let it scare you. It's just math, okay? If your math is not mathing, calm down. Take a deep breath. Take a walk. Take a chill pill. Talk to someone to give you a positive vibe, okay? Speak positive into your life and pray. Add prayers to it. Ask the heavens to back you because you're a child of the Most High God. I believe this motivation about dosage calculation. I did the same with capstone when I got there. I was stressful. Everything was going on, okay? So I had to take it the second time, and the second time I passed. I did the same formula I just gave you, and I passed. I know you got this. Don't let dosage calculations scare you, okay? You got this. You're gonna make it, okay? All right. Let me know if you need anything, any help, anybody to motivate you. If you're already in the program, you're about to get in the program, hit me on WhatsApp. Join the Telegram group, and I promise you I'll make some time and encourage and motivate you, okay? You got a sister in me. All right, God bless you.